Good evening, friends. Now I am going to discuss a very small chapter from where every year 4 to 5 marks are usually asked in the CSIR NET examination. So the name of this is macromolecules, or you may call as polymer. So I will cover all the important formulas and just the basic concept behind those things, and I will not go in details, but if you can remember all this formula which are written in this board, you will be able to answer all the questions from this chapter. Anyway, so first is the number average molar mass. So what is number average molar mass? Number average molar mass is designated as mn bar, which is equal to ni mi by ni, that is summation ni mi by summation ni. So where ni is the number of monomer unit having a molar number of the monomer having mass mi. So we can write as n1 m1 plus n2 m2 plus dot 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 by n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus n4, like this. Okay, so this is the number of monomers having molar mass m1. This is n2 is the number of monomers having molar mass m2, and it goes like this. So this number average molar mass is calculated by osmometry. So it's an experimental method to calculate the number average molar mass. Next comes the mass average molar mass, or in some books it's written as weight average molar mass. So it is designated as MW bar or MM bar sometimes. So it is summation ni mi square by summation ni mi. So it comes to be n1 m1 square plus n2 m2 square, like this, by n1 m1 plus n2 m2. So this is determined experimentally by light scattering. So light scattering method is used to determine the mass average molar mass. This comes the polydispersity. So what is polydispersity? It's clearly written, it is a heterogeneity in the sample or in the polymer sample. That means that where the monomer molecules are not identical chemically, or neither in terms of size. That is the heterogeneity in the polymer sample. So the polydispersity index is equal to the mass average molar mass divided by the number average molar mass. So MW by MN. So for a polydispersed sample, MW is always greater than MN. That means PDI, that is polydispersity index, is always greater than 1. But for a monodispersed sample where there is no heterogeneity, MW is equal to MN. That means PDI is 1 for a monodispersed polymer sample. Next comes the Z average molar mass, which is written as MZ bar. That is summation ni mi cube divided by summation ni mi square. And this Z average molar mass is determined by sedimentation method experimentally. Next is the viscosity average molar mass. So this is actually calculated from Mark-Hawing equation, and for like the intrinsic viscosity is equal to some constant into the viscosity average molar mass to the power some constant. Okay. So what is the intrinsic viscosity? It's nothing but the limit concentration tends to zero, eta minus eta zero by eta zero into 1 by C. So this eta is the viscosity of the solution. When we dissolve the polymer, this is the viscosity of the solution. And eta zero is the viscosity of the pure solvent. And C is the concentration of the polymer. So from here, if we get this intrinsic value, and if you are given the K and alpha value, you can easily get the viscosity average molar mass. So ln eta is equal to ln K plus alpha ln mv. So if we plot this value, from here we can get the K and alpha value from the slope and intercept. Then is osmometry method. I told earlier that osmometry method is used to determine the number average molar mass. So this is pi by C is RT by M plus B2C RT plus dot. These are the virial coefficient. And so if we plot pi by C versus C, so we will get the intercept RT by M. So if we extrapolate this plot at C tends to 0, then we will get the intercept as rt by m. So limit c tends to 0, pi by c is equal to rt by m. So if we know the value of this intercept, and if we know the T value at temperature, R is a constant, we can easily get M value. So this M is basically the number average molar mass. Next is, we have a polymer chain. So in order to find the contour length, what is the formula of contour length? Is equal to N into L. N is the number of monomers that forms the polymer, and L is the length of the monomer unit, right? So contour length is N into L. So if you know the number of monomers, if you know the length of those monomers, you can find the contour length. So contour length N into L, the root mean square length, RMS, that is root N into L. And average length is 8 by 3 pi to the power half root N into L. And our most probable is R 2 by 3 to the power half root N into L. And next, the RG, that is the average RMS distance, average root mean square distance, is also called the radius of gyration. This is equal to 1 by root 6 of R RMS, means what we will get here by root 6. Okay, this is for a linear coil polymer. Now for polymers, if P is the probability of link of polymer chain, if the P is the probability of link of polymer chain, then the mole fraction of KMR formation is basically P to the power K minus 1 into 1 minus P. Where K is the KMR, means the number of monomer. Okay, so if we have 10 or 50 value, then this will be 50. K will be 50, 50 monomers unit. And what is the average value of the link? That is the K average. The average value of the link is equal to 1 by 1 minus P. Right, so from here sometimes numerical comes, and this straight cut formula came in June 2016, and this type of formula based numericals are also asked. So that's all for this chapter. Actually, there are not so much thing in this chapter, only you should learn this formulas, only this formula. Just learn this formula and just practice it. It will take hardly 1.5 to 2 hours, and you will surely get 4 marks out of it. That's for sure. So I will discuss a few numericals which has been asked in the CSIR NET exam in the previous years. So I will do it soon. And that's all for this video. So thanks a lot for watching this video.